Today, as promised, I'll show you my take on a 120% hydration sourdough bread. My name is Stefano. If you are new to this channel, click like and consider subscribing to be part of the conversation. Let's start with the ingredients. 150 grams wholemeal flour, 150 grams bread flour, 200 grams water, 100 grams sourdough starter, feed 3 times, 5 grams malt, 170 grams ice water and 10 grams sea salt. Combine the two flour in a kitchenette bowl and hydrate with 200 grams water. Mix by hand until the mixture is dry and well hydrated. Let it rest for an hour in autolysis. I covered autolysis in previous video, but if you need a refresh, I will leave the link in the description below. One of your comments regarding sourdough said, how many steps? Does it really take 2 days for this recipe? Well, if you can organize your schedule, that's the best. But just because you mentioned that, I will try to make this bread in a single day. After the autolysis, add 5 grams malt and 100 grams sourdough starter and start kneading on a kitchenette machine with the flat beater attachment at low speed. Now, one of the crucial steps to obtain a well-kneaded dough and to form gluten development is to add our 170 grams of remaining water little by little. Always wait until the liquid is well absorbed before adding more. In this recipe, I incorporated the liquid in 5 parts. From start to finish, about 25 minutes has passed. Checking the dough temperature to make sure not to make it hot, which is why it's recommended to use ice water for this application. Before to finish the water, don't forget to add salt and let it absorb. Next to its role in boosting the flavor of your bread, salt plays a role in tightening the gluten structure and adding strength to your dough. It helps the loaf to hold on the carbon dioxide gas that is formed during fermentation, supporting good volume. Time to see the consistency of a 120% hydration dough. The mix is super liquid, stretchy, with a great gluten development, wet and a bit sticky, but still decent in my opinion to try and attempt to shape our bread. Here I'm trying to form a ball that I will place in a narrow container, cover with glad wrap film that will rest for an hour. After this period, put the mass in a bowl filled with flour. Take the side and pull them toward the center in a circular way to give structure to the dough. Here the high hydration begins to impose itself over the attempt to give shape to the bread. In fact, the dough will inexorably return to a flat shape. Let's flip the mixture on a working surface. That's cool, isn't it? It almost looks like jelly. I definitely love this dough. Here I try to get tension surface by turning the dough toward myself with my hands. Rest for 5 minutes and let's try the final shape. Flip the dough upside down, spread it to form a rectangle and pull the edges to the center in this way. Roll it up on itself and place it on a bread basket previously sprinkled with rice flour that works perfectly to avoid sticking the dough on the basket. Give a final fermentation for 2 additional hours. Let's see how the dough behaved. Turn it gently on a baking paper and voila, still flat. Then let's try to bake it. In a 250 degrees Celsius preheated oven, our flat bread it goes, cover, add ice to create nice steam and cook for 20 minutes. 20 minutes later, remove the cover, lower the temperature to 200 degrees Celsius and cook for an additional 20 minutes or until your favorite color crust. I knew that with this high hydration, I won't have obtained a perfect structure and volume. But I must say, it doesn't look so bad to me. Let it cool for a couple of hours. Now, time for the cut. I'm always curious to see the inside and, as I supposed, large bubble. You can see through. This was definitely a fun baking. I will upload in more sourdough bread videos in the coming weeks. But until then, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell and I promise you, we keep on this conversation.